This video is going to be about addition in bases other than base 10. So here's the first problem. We've got these two base 5 numbers, 2, 3, 2, and 3, 4, 1. And let's say that I actually live in a base 5 world, where everybody uses base 5. And I've got to add these two numbers, but I haven't bothered to memorize my addition facts. So one thing I could do is I could draw a number line. I'm also assuming I don't have a base 5 calculator handy. So I'm going to draw a number line. I'll start at 0, and then a 1, and a 2, a 3, a 4. Now, in the base 5 world, there's only 5 digits, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. After 4, I have 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, and so on. So let's use the number line to do this addition problem. I've got to add a 2 and a 1. So I'm going to start at the 2. When I use my number line, I'm always going to start at the larger of the two numbers. I start at the 2 and go over one space to the right. I count up 1, and that means that I'm at 3. So 2 plus 1 must equal 3. Now I've got to add 3 and a 4. So I'll go to the larger of those numbers. I'll go to the 4 on the number line. Now count up 3 spaces, 1, 2, 3. That gets me to the number 1, 2. So I'll write the 2 down and carry a 1 into the next column. Now I've got to add 1 plus 2 plus 3. Well, I know that 1 plus 2 is 3. I learned that in my first column, and I've got to add 3 plus 3. So I'll go to the number line, I'll go to the 3, count up 3 spaces, 1, 2, 3. And that gets me to 1, 1, 2, 3, base 5. Now, let's say I don't even want to use a number line. I can do this again just using my fingers. Okay, so I've got to add 2 and 1. After the 2, I'm going to count up 1. We're assuming I've learned how to count. So from 2, I just count up 1, and that's 3. I've got to add 3 and 4. So I'm going to start at the 4 and count up 3 more. 4, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. So I'll write the 2, carry the 1 to the next column. I can add the 1 and the 2 because I know from the first column that that's 3. And I've got to add 3 more, so I'll count up 3 more fingers. So I've got 3, 4, 1, 0, 1, 1. And once again, I get 1, 1, 2, 3, base 5. Okay? Now, if I had had an addition table, I could have referred to the addition table for these facts. But in this case, I just wanted to do it with my fingers. Okay, so let's try another problem. Let's say we're now in a different world, and this world is a base 8 world. So I've got the numbers 5, 7, 2, and 4, 7, 3. And I have to add those together. So I'm going to do those without a number line. So I have to add the 3 and the 2. And once again, we're assuming I've learned how to count. So 3, and I want to add 2 more fingers. 3, 4, 5. So 3 plus 2 is 5. Now I've got to add 7 and 7, and I really don't want to bother with all those fingers. So here's a nice trick I've learned. In base 8, 7 would equal 1, 0, minus 1. So think about this. If I counted 1 up from 7, I would get to 1, 0. And then if I took 1 away from that 1, 0, I would get back down to 7. So 7 equals 1, 0, minus 1. If you happen to live in a base 10 world, this is like saying that 9 equals 10 minus 1. But we're assuming we're in a base 8 world, so I'm going to get rid of that fact. Okay, so 7 equals 1, 0, minus 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cross out one of these 7s, and I'm going to write 1, 0 instead. I'll write the 1 over in the next column, and the 0 over where I've crossed out the 7. But I need that minus 1 part, so I'm going to cross out the other 7, and I'll call that a 6, which is 1 less than 7. Now all I've got to do is add 6 and 0. Well, that's 6. And then I've got to add 1 plus 5 plus 4. Well, counting up from 5, counting up the 1 first, that's just 6. And then I have to add 6 and 4. So let's see, I've got 6, I'll use my fingers, 7, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. So now I've got my answer. 1, 2, 6, 5, base 8. Now I could have used a number line for this. I could have used an addition table for this, or I could have just memorized my addition facts. But I wanted to show you how to do this. I also wanted you to see how you can, kinds of tricks you can use, like when you had to add 7 and 7. And you might want to take a moment and think about how you would do these same things if you were in the same kind of position in your own base 10 world. In other words, let's say you hadn't memorized your numbers, your math facts. How would you go about doing a problem like this? So it might give you some insight into how we operate in base 10. Okay, that's it for now. Take care, and I'll see you next time.